Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Deborah Lee Scott, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Buliforce as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78, Gene Rayburn.
What's going on? What?
Charles is telling me how to take a triangle flight.
A triangle flight. Oh, we must all do that once a lifetime.
I'd rather take a triumvirate flight.
Okay, anything you say.
You mean another say? Person.
Nothing.
You have something to say?
I already gave.
You already gave. Well, let's welcome this cute little old winemaker, Bill Stevens, here. Hello, Bill. Time ran out. He won the game. Did the first part of the audience match, won his $100. Now he's going to play either for $1,000 or $2,000, depending on the spin of the wheel. We'll get to that right after we finish this for you. You want to go up there? What the hell do I care? Get up there. Stand anywhere you want. You're a nifty guy. Wait a minute. Not until I tell you to. Hold on. Now, wait a minute. It's my show, Bill. Let's get this straight. There are certain things I have to say so that everybody knows what's going on, because, you know, the wheel is still kind of new. We're only in our second week with it here. All the celebrities' names are on the wheel. You're going to spin it now to determine whether you're playing for $1,000 or $2,000. If it lands in one of the starred areas, it means you'll be playing for $2,000. And then all their names there, whichever name it finishes up on, is the celebrity you'll be playing with. Now, are you ready to spin it?
Don't forget about a full circle.
Yes, right. One complete rotation. So you have to give it a good spin, okay?
After I spin it, can I use my thumb here?
No. We must be both hands at all times. All right. Good luck, Bill. Bing.
Come on. Hit it. Go.
All right. It's made one complete rotation. Let's see if it's going to stop in the goal part there. Come on. Okay, let's go down here now. There's a step there.
Is that me?
It is a double. And you're playing with Deborah Lee Scott here now.
How you doing?
You ready for her?
I'll try to be.
I'm sure you are.
Okay, you have to face me. I know it's better looking at Deborah Lee than looking at me, but such is life, pal. Good luck to you. He's going to play for the double. He spun that lucky wheel there, and he did well with it. Here it is. Scrub blank. That's S-C-R-U-B blank. Scrub blank.
Oh, Bill.
Scrub blank. Now, Deborah Lee is finished. You give us the answer that she's written on the card. We give you $2,000. Isn't that easy?
Oh, that's simple.
Yes. What do you say?
Brush.
Brush. Deborah Lee, he says scrub brush will match you for $2,000.
Well, I'm not much of a domestic, but I did say brush.
You did! Congratulations, Bill. You now have $2,200. And your wife is very happy out there. She's about to cry.
Second row.
She's in the second row. We got a picture of her. See her on camera over there? See her shot over there?
Yeah.
There she is. Okay. Now let's meet your new player. Are you ready for that?
Ready.
Are we going too fast for you?
Oh, let's go.
All right, let's go. Here comes Jennifer Scanlon. Hi, Jennifer. As soon as it stops. There you go, Bill. Jennifer, you know Bill Stevens.
Sure do. Hi, Bill.
Lucky Bill Stevens, who knows how to spin that wheel so it stops
beautiful.
On the double money. Where are you from, Jennifer?
Well, I'm originally from Farmington, New Mexico.
Really? You live here now?
I've been here about 5 years.
You like it here?
Love it.
Terrific.
Just got a beautiful little house down by the beach in Belmont Shore.
Yeah.
It's great.
Mm-hmm. Do you work?
I'm a waitress.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Single.
Yeah.
I'd throw that in.
Later, fellas. Later. Now we have to play the game. I mean this game here. You ready for this game?
Sure am.
Good luck to both of you. Are you ready to continue?
Ready.
All right. Now, Jennifer has a choice of A or B.
A.
All right. This one says, the Hollywood producer said. Hollywood producer said, I've heard of bad casting, but this is ridiculous. The studio is doing the life story of Twiggy. For the starring role, they picked blank. Jennifer, do you know who Twiggy is? Okay.
Well, I don't know what you're not supposed to say, and I don't know what you are supposed to say.
Are you ready,
yeah,
Jennifer?
Yeah, sure am. That's a sneaky question.
Okay. Hollywood producer said, I've heard of bad casting, but this is ridiculous. The studio's doing the life story of Twiggy. For the starring role, they picked...
Mama Cass.
Mama Cass. They picked Mama Cass. Gross,
I swear to you, that's the first thing that came to my mind, and I thought, nah.
No one would say that.
Yeah.
Oh, too bad.
Mainly because she's dead.
Yes, right. But...
Well, that's part of it. And then I thought, I'm a lot old. Maybe she's, I don't know. So I did second best. Kate Smith.
Kate Smith.
I thought of that one, too.
You thought of that one, too, Jennifer, and you rejected that. Well, they've rejected each other.
Well, I try to stick very close to home.
Yes.
And what was Twiggy known for?
For being skinny.
Yeah, and she was as flat as a pancake everywhere in life, right?
Right, indeed. Right.
So I picked the person we know and love so well.
Who is well endowed.
Fanny Flagg.
Fanny Flagg.
Hi, Fanny. Come on home, darling. We miss you.
All is forgiven. Okay, Chuck. There's not a bad explanation for a rotten answer. No, I'm only kidding. It's good.
You sure?
But for box office, we'll get Liz Taylor.
Liz Taylor. Right. It's up. What's up front that counts? What else? Hello, Deborah Lee.
And this lady has a lot up front that counts. Raquel.
Raquel.
Woo!
Jennifer is looking for Mama Cass.
Raquel, part two.
Raquel. Bella ragazza questa.
This lady fell down and it took four men to carry her out, two abreast. Mae West.
Mae West. Okay, we'll get to you in a moment. Right now, we've got this for America. Pay attention. All right, we're ready to go on now. This is the other half of round one. Bill, it's your question. Listen carefully. Steve said, I think there's too much stress on entertainment in the news. Last night, when I turned on my TV, Walter Cronkite was reading the news and blanking. Too much stress on entertainment in the news. Last night, when I turned in... Walter Cronkite was reading the news and blanking.
I love Walter Cronkite.
I love Walter Cronkite. And I love Betsy Cronkite.
I don't know Betsy. I just
Betsy is cute as a bug. Okay.
I finished.
Good for you. Okay, good, Chuck. Hello, Bill.
Hello,
Gene. How you doing?
No worse.
Steve said, I think there's too much stress on entertainment in the news. Last night, when I turned on my TV, Walter Cronkite was reading the news and blanking.
Dancing.
Dancing. Very good. Hey, look at me. I'm dancing. Yes?
I would like to pass this round.
Okay. Brett, what have you got?
He has to play on it. You've forgotten the rules.
I'll call on him later.
You're going to call on him later?
I'll call. See, after he's heard a couple of rotten answers, he won't feel so bad about his answers. So I'll call on you, then Charles, then I'll come back to Henry.
You've got the wrong murderer.
Oh, I see.
I don't have a rotten
answer. Oh, you have a goodie here.
I have a wonderful answer. Dancing after the ball is over.
Dancing.
Attaboy, Bill Cuban.
Okay.
Prelude to Henry. Juggling. Yes!
Juggling.
Don't encourage
me. All right. You will let me know when you're ready, will you, Henry?
No.
No. All right. All right, Deborah Lee, what do you got there?
It's not going to help Henry any. I said dancing.
Dancing.
Just
Henry, you may have made a mistake because if all these nifty answers keep coming up, it's going to be worse than ever when we come to you.
No, I've saved Henry.
You've saved Henry?
Laughing.
Okay, now we can go to you, Henry.
This is shameful for a man of my age and weight.
Yes.
This is impossible. If he's reading the news, how could he be whistling?
Oh, wouldn't that be different? Today, in the Middle East... No, it can't be done. It can't be done.
Oh,
we're up to you.
Can Henry come back more often when I'm here? It makes me feel so bright. Sorry, Henry. Did you spell it right?
Yes, he did.
Spelled it.
Oh, his spelling is terrific.
I said dancing.
Dancing. Well, Bill, that's most unusual. You get three in a first round, Jennifer, A or B.
I'm going to go with A again.
A again. Everybody plays because she didn't match anybody in the first round. Rick said.
Yeah.
My friend Joe doesn't trust anybody anymore. He hasn't been the same since he jumped on his bicycle and discovered that someone had stolen the blank. Okay. Rick said my friend Joe doesn't trust anybody anymore. He hasn't been the same since he jumped on his bicycle and discovered that someone had stolen the blank.
Seat.
Yes, sir?
Again, did you, Henry?
I suppose you think I can do two in a row, don't you?
We were hoping.
Well, this one even suits my small brain.
Yes.
Seat.
Seat it is. One for Jennifer.
Show us your seat, honey.
You'll be singing soprano.
Okay.
I chose seat, too.
Okay. It would be tough if someone stole the handlebars, too, because you wouldn't know whether you were coming or going. What do you got there?
Seat.
Seat it is. Four for her. Score is now 4-3. Richard, yeah, give us his seat, too, there. I don't expect too much, Jennifer, because you're coming to... what's her name here? Handlebars?
I got a good seat.
Oh, you have? Okay. Now, Bill... You got one shot at it here. The best you could do is tie. However, that's possible if you match Henry, Charles, and Richard, the three men.
Yo!
Okay. Weird Wanda is really weird.
How weird is she?
Her bra consists of two cups and two blanks. Oh, this is a good one.
Am I allowed to give my theory on how to cut down on junk mail while everyone is answering?
No, thank you. You can get on a list, you know. Okay,
I'm
everybody
on everybody's
ready?
List.
Then you got to match everybody. Think about it carefully. Weird Wanda is really weird. Her bra, you remember what they are.
Okay. I hear it, Carol.
Yeah. Her bra consists of two cups and two blanks.
Saucers.
Yeah. Shut up, boy. Judging from the audience reaction, Henry, if you don't say saucers, they're going to lynch you right on the spot. What is the... They're going to lynch you right on the spot.
No, the word.
Saucers.
Saucers.
Saucers, what he says. Hey,
I get it, cups.
Cups and saucers. Oh, you finally... What?
Saucers.
Okay. You must say saucers.
Well, I went to space age. You know that's the space age now.
Two cups and two...
Saucers.
Oh, saucers. Tricky Charlie there. All right, Richard. Excuse me, I got... Weird Wanda, really weird. Her bra consists of two cups and two... Do we get a tie?
Yeah!
Yeah!
Yes,
six to six to score. Don't nobody move. We got a little message for America. Thank you. We are going to roll along. We'll turn off the lights here. Push the button. Reveal one tie-breaking question for each of you. The one who's matched the most will be the winner, Jennifer.
A again.
She's stuck with A all along here. Bill said, I'm trying to teach my little baby how to play basketball. But so far, the only thing he can do is blank. It's very easy.
I'm trying to teach my little baby how to play basketball. But so far, the only thing he can do is...
That is all the help I can give you is let you read the question. Everybody understands it as clearly as possible. Everybody in the lower tier is ready. Get with it, Brett.
Okay, sweetheart.
Henry, ready? Here we go. Bill said, I'm trying to teach my little baby how to play basketball. But so far, the only thing he can do is...
Dribble.
Yeah! Dribble. Yeah, he's got it. She saved dribble, which is a pretty good answer.
Exquisite. I didn't know how to do that.
How to dribble?
I'm an expert.
Oh, I see.
Dribble.
Dribble is what she said.
I thought you said drizzle, and I had a winner here.
Uh-oh. What does that mean?
What does that mean?
M-N-O, and I didn't want to do the next one.
Okay. Whatever.
L.
Oh, I see.
M-N-O. What does the baby know how to do?
Can't spell, right. M-N-N-U-N-A-N-A-M-N-O-R-N-I-N-A. What have you got there?
I think it's the same thing. I just phrased it a little differently. I said wet a dry diaper.
Wet a dry diaper. Okay. Wet a dry diaper does not match dribble.
Wet a dry diaper is not... It's a song title.
Okay.
Wet a dry diaper.
Okay, I guess we got to have an exact dribble here. What have you got?
Right on the air.
Right on the air.
Gene, being so connected to sports like
yes.
I am, dribble.
You said dribble. Deborah Lee.
Yeah.
I'm trying to teach a kid how to play basketball. So far, the only thing you can do is dribble.
Oh, well, I don't know nothing about babies or basketball, but I said dribble.
All right. Super Jennifer.
So I know a little something, huh?
Right.
It's also the only thing Chuck Barris can do. Dribble. You ever noticed how he dribbles?
Yes. Hello there.
I don't understand why Henry's answer doesn't match. M-N-O. Is the same thing as dribbling?
No. No. No.
In a sense?
No, in a sense.
Dribble.
Okay.
All right.
Now, Bill, the way it is, you need 4 to tie, 5 to win. Dumb Donald was so dumb. When he got his marriage license, he put it on his blank. That's how dumb he was. When he got his marriage license, he put it on his blank. Bill Stevens, are you ready?
I hope.
Dumb Donald was so dumb when he got his marriage license, he put it on his blank.
His car.
Car it is. Dumb Donald was so dumb he put his marriage license, put it on his...
Too late for dribble, huh?
Yeah, too late for dribble.
Put it on his car.
On his C-A-R car.
It's car or automobile.
Car, automobile. Either way it works. That's two for him. The score is now 4-2.
Another point for the granddaddy.
All right. Are you a great-grandfather? A great-grandfather. Deborah Lee Scott.
Does he want the point taken back or why?
No.
Yes?
When he got
his marriage
license,
he put
it on his...
Car.
Car it is.
The only place to put a marriage license.
Now, one more, Bill, and you will have won the game. Richard? Car it is. What do you have? While he's making his way to the blue spot there, we'll say goodbye to Jennifer Scanlon.
Yes, thank you very much.
It was a pleasure to meet you, my dear. We're going to get many gifts for you for
Great.
Match Game 78.
Thank
Jennifer
you.
Scanlon, let's spin her off and spin a message just for you. There it is. And I'd like to thank each and every one of them. Does anybody have anything to plug? Any movies or any plays or any personal appearances?
I got Little Women. I did Little Women.
It's all past in the past?
Well, it'll be on not till Christmas.
Well, I mean, you filmed it.
But it was fun, yeah.
Yes,
what you play, Marmy?
No, darling. Yeah. Dorothy McGuire played Marmy, and Greer Garson played the auntie. I played Mrs. Kerka.
Well, we look forward to seeing that. Yeah. Thank you for mentioning that. I hope you'll all join us next time here for Match Game 78. Dean Rayburn, goodbye.